Hello, in this video I will show you some of the classic mistakes made with Shape3d, and how to avoid them. One of the first classic mistakes that we can see when someone is starting and has double-clicked anywhere by accident, are points superimposed on curves. For example here, if I click once, I see the tangent on one side. I click again, it is on the other side. So there is a problem. If I zoom in, I realize that there are two points on top of each other. This must be avoided, because it gives breaks in the curves. In this case, we delete the second point. We see that Shape3d has modified the first point automatically to keep almost the same curve. Similarly, another problem that we can see, it is for example here if I move my mouse with left button pressed to see the shape of the board along X. I see that there is a jump in the slice. And here, when I click in the slice panel, in the list of slices I see that there are indeed two, which are almost in the same place. So we have to delete one of them. I click here to see the properties, and then delete. Now we see that we have a good continuity. I do undo to put the original board back. To easily detect these errors, I press the E key on the keyboard. We see that the two superimposed points appear as a big green dot. And the two superimposed slices appear as a big red line. This makes it easy to detect errors. Beyond the superimposed points, you must also pay attention to the tangents of the points. Above all, avoid them being too short. Sometimes we see people who, to make angles or straight sections, will bring the tangent back to the control point, thinking that the result is correct. But if we zoom in, we see that it can make kinks or loops, which can give bad results to interpolation or cutting. In this case, it is better to keep a visible tangent length, even if it means forcing the straight section. I click on undo to put it back as before. Now, another classic error that we can see concerns the apex of the slices. The widest point here is green, and if I select it, we see that it is marked as apex. And the blue point here is marked as rail. The others are marked as normal. The point defined as the apex must always be the widest point. For that, it must have a vertical tangent. If you have a tangent with a slight angle, the widest point is then marked with a small red line. The problem that this can cause in this case, is that, when CNC cutting, all the space between the apex point and the true widest point will not be cut. So you should avoid it. And always have a vertical tangent at the apex. The definition of the rail point is not mandatory. However, it allows for a cleaner cut at the tuck in CNC mode. And it is also useful when you design channels with 3D layers. If these channels come out of the board, this allows for a clean transition. Note that you can also define a rail point on top. Then, there is a rail point below, and a rail point above. This rail point above will be useful if you have 3D layers, with the map on extended rail option on the deck. On the slice, we can note that, if you want to have a deck without a break on the top, you must have a horizontal tangent on the central point of the deck. For the bottom, if you want to have a V or a double concave, you leave a free tangent. But if you want to have a simple concave and therefore a continuous bottom, you also need a horizontal tangent. Another mistake that we sometimes see, for example when we want to make a board with a round tail, is to bring the back point of the outline to Y equals 0, completely on the axis. At this point, we see that the slice of the tail, so slice 1, is nothing more than a straight vertical line, and that it becomes difficult to work on it. In this case, note that Shape3d does not take into account the slice 1. and therefore it is only slice 2, which is used to generate the shape of the tail of the board. Here, for example, since this slice has a double concave, when the board becomes very thin at the tail, this double concave becomes very pronounced. In general, we want to avoid it. Beyond the very pronounced concave, there may be a problem if the first point of the outline is not at y equals 0, but almost at 0. Let's say, for example, 0.0001 inches. Then, slice 1 is still very thin, almost unusable. But Shape3d will not detect it as being of 0 width, and it will still use it for the interpolation. So if you modify slice 2, for example by putting a flat bottom, thinking that it would be applied to the whole tail, you will realize that it does not work. You still have a strong concave at the tip, and you are unable to modify this strong concave on slice 1. So you must always be careful to keep 1 or 2 millimeters of width, even for a round or pintail. Note that 1 or 2 millimeters is always smaller than the width of the stringer. So it doesn't really have an influence, and it allows you to manage the shape of the back by putting, for example, a flat bottom. I use the align selected points function here. This problem of the tail with a width reduced to 0 will also be important for boards like this one, for example, where there are several curves edited in the top view. This is a board with wings where we edited the curve corresponding to the deck 1 point, so as not to have the breakage that is reflected on the deck. Here the tail slice is pinched. And if now I want to widen the tail to design it, we will have to be careful to widen not only the apex curve, but also the deck 1 curve. With very thin tails like that, with several edited curves, we will have to be careful that the tail is well defined, because the slice 1 will have an influence on the interpolation until the next slice. For example here, if I don't widen it as it should, then I have to adapt the height of the point on the slice, so that the shape remains correct. There can be another complication in the case where the curve corresponding to this point, deck 1, is also edited in the side view. Here, for example, I right-click on the curve deck 1 in the list to edit it. So the height of the point on the slice is determined by the curve in the side view. If I lower it here, it lowers the point on the slice. And I can't move this point in the slice view anymore. You have to be careful that the curves, in the top view and in the side view, are in agreement, to have a couple that has the shape we want, and that the interpolation to the next couple is correct. Generally speaking, to have a shape that is smooth and that is not too complicated to modify, you have to avoid having too many points on the curves, too many slices and too many edited curves. For example, if I take this file, typically this is a file that will be complicated to modify. We would do well to simplify it before any modification. Let's hide the 3D layers. We can start by looking if all these points are needed on the slices. Then we have to ask ourselves if all these curves edited in the top view and the side view are needed. For example, the deck 5 curve here is needed because it draws the bump around the mast foot. Then the deck 3 curve allows us to remove this bump. But the deck 2 curve has the same regular shape and is therefore not useful. If I right-click in the list to unedit it, we see that the curve has not moved. So there was no need to edit it. This one is not necessary either. Then there is the apex. The rail curve also looks similar to the apex curve, so it does not need to be edited. I unedit it. That already makes fewer curves to modify. Same in the side view. There is the apex. The deck 1 curve doesn't need to be edited. Neither does deck 2. Maybe deck 3, for the mast foot bump. Then there's the stringer top. There you go. Then on the slices, you can see that the curve between here and there is pretty much regular. So this deck 1 point is definitely not needed. If I delete it, the curve doesn't move. That's one less point on each slice. That'll make it easier to edit. This point is perhaps necessary because it creates a small bump. But this one is perhaps not necessary. If I delete, we see that the curve does not move. That already gives us a much simpler board to modify. Then, if we look at the slices here, there are a lot of them. This slice, a priori, is not necessary. Besides, if I delete it, I press the delete key, and then I put my mouse with left button pressed here, I don't see any change in shape. So we can delete like that the slices that are not necessary, because the interpolation already gives the shape we want. This will make a smoother file and easier to modify. Then we will have to check each slice. For example, here, there is a red line. That means that this tangent is either not vertical, or, as here, that there is another tangent wider than the apex. We modify it to have the wider point at the apex. Same here. We see that there are two points that are very close to each other. It's worth checking that there is not an angle between the two. The middle tangent is not defined as horizontal. We can see that it makes a small bump. I press the Shift key on the keyboard to select the two points. Then, right-click and align selected points horizontally. To have something more regular, we can then do the same thing on the other slices. But in fact, here we can certainly still delete more slices. In general, we need much less than that, except in special cases. And we can certainly also delete quite a few control points, because the curves are smooth and in general a smooth curve only needs 3 to 4 control points at most. Now we will see another error that we sometimes see when someone wants to draw a swallowtail. If he tries to draw it directly with the apex curve, or outline. For example, by moving this point to have a swallowtail like this. But actually, when we look at the curve fill, we see that there is a straight line here. And if I look at it in 3D, the board actually stops at the X of the first point, which is always placed at X equals 0. The right way to design a swallowtail is to use a 3D layer. The easiest is a vertical cut 3D layer. Here I replace this tail by a square tail. And I click on the new 3D layer button. I select the vertical cut type. Between 0 and 1 inch, for example. Between the center and the outline extension curve. And I can draw my swallowtail as I like. Now you can see the swallowtail in the 3D. About the swallowtail design, there are two errors that we see classically. It is either that this point they're placed wider than the outline of the board. At this point, in fact, it will shorten the board. It will stop here instead of starting at X equals 0. Or another problem that we see sometimes, it's when someone positioned this point with the mouse. Without looking too much in detail, and positioned it at an X greater than 0. At that point, in 3D we'll see a bar like this. Because the swallowtail doesn't start right at the tail of the board, at X equals 0. There are other ways to design swallowtails, with rounded rails, more or less technical. But you can see that in other videos. Another classic mistake that can be seen on 3D layers, is for example this case, a stand-up with recessed deck. If I look at the 3D and zoom in on the front, I see that it has a small bump at the front. It's not very clean. And if I move my mouse here with the left button pressed, I see that where the center of the recessed deck becomes higher than the edge, the slice flips. And here I have a bump. In this case, what we need to do is insert a slice at the front of the 3D layer. Right-click, Slices, add new slice on selected 3D layer. Then use the function Shift plus right click, stick selected slice to original shape. Now, if we look at the interpolation, we see that we have no more bump, and therefore no more bulge in 3D. You should not hesitate to do this at both ends of the 3D layers, at the front and at the back. A final case that we can see is the case where we draw channels that come out of the board. To make a channel, I will use a 3D layer of type twin, which we will put on the bottom, between 0 and 2 feet. I will make a channel that starts here and comes out of the board at the tail. I press Shift for multiple selection, then right click, align selected points. I position the inner curve of the channel. Here too, Shift for multiple selection, right click, align selected points. And here I will give its shape to the slice of the channel. To make this channel disappear at the front, we must not forget to insert a slice in front of the channel. I use the function Shift plus right click, stick selected slice to original shape, to have a channel that disappears at the front. The channel looks fine, except here at the tail, where it comes out of the board. You can see that there is a dropout. And that is because the channel slice is stuck to the bottom of the board. And where it goes past the rail point, it will go up along the rail. And that is what causes the kink. To avoid this, there is a ready-made and very simple option. This is the map on extended rail option of the 3D layers. At this point, the slice of the 3D layer will not be stuck on the rail, but on the extension of the tangent of the rail point, here. And so with this option we will be able to remove the kink. But be careful, this function will depend on the tangent of the rail point. If the tangent, instead of being horizontal or almost, it is pointed downwards, like this, then the channel will stick to the extension of the tangent, and it will end up going up very high, like this. So, when you use the map on extended rail function, you have to be careful that the tangents of the rail point are defined properly. There you go, that's already a lot of mistakes to avoid, and a good basis for designing your boards with Shape3d. See you soon.